especially in the red zone.
Yeah, it's great. Obviously, you know, we love having AJ out there, and he's a playmaker. So, you know, if we can get him out there, we're going to be thankful for it, and he's going to make plays. So, glad to have him back out there today.
You guys were able to convert a lot of big third downs, especially in that first half, and keep drives going. How critical was that, and how did you guys get out to the lead?
Yeah, it was huge. You know, I think it's big every week, right? It's just being able to sustain those drives, getting to third downs, being able to convert, keep those drives going, and get a chance to sustain that drive and put points on the board. So proud of our guys. Felt like we came in with a good plan and then executed it well on those third downs.
You're going to take punches, I guess, from teams in this league. It kind of went back and forth already. You guys had a 17 unanswered at one point. How important is it to kind of stay in the fight, weather the storm, and then do you feel like you guys did a good job at that?
Yeah, no doubt. It's a tough league, right? Nothing is going to come easy. So got to stay out there, battle, stay together. You know, something doesn't go your way or things are going your way, it doesn't really matter. You got to stay the course and keep pushing forward.
We saw how much you and Marcus Johnson were able to get on the same page throughout the course of training camp. How good was it to have him out there today and have that kind of materialize in front of everybody?
Yeah, it was great to have Marcus out there. You know, a guy that, like you mentioned, was big for us during training camp, you know, built a lot of chemistry with him, had some sideline adjustments, and we were able to go out and execute on the field, made a big play over the middle, which was huge for us, getting a drive going on an explosive. So great to have Marcus back out there for sure.
You like seeing that from a guy that's, you know, had a great camp, all of a sudden, you know, he had the injury, but he's able to come in and be ready to go on a day like today?
Oh, it's huge. You know, whenever you have guys that you've built up reps with that have been away, and then they're able to step right in and pick up where they left off, you know, it's huge and gives us more depth and guys that we can create matchups for and get open.
It was another really good day for Derrick Henry. I mean, are you guys kind of like at a point where it's just like, hey, man, that's just Derrick being Derrick? Despite, you know, every week we say, oh, yeah, he's with this Hall of Famer or that Hall of Famer. But, like, do you ever take that, like, that's just him just doing what he does?
Yeah, Derrick does a great job pretty much every week. You know, you look at, you know, what he's done over the course of his career, you know, especially the last 3 years. I mean, he's big, he's physical, he's tough, he runs hard, and he's durable. So, you know, it's fun to be able to play with them for sure.
Taylor mentioned that in years past, when you guys would get up, if this Jags defense would sort of give up, you gave them credit for continuing to fight today. Did you see that? And what differences do you see from when you played them in years past?
I don't know. It's tough to sit here and compare to years past, but definitely have respect for the way they played. They came out and played us hard, played us tough, and weren't giving up anything easy for sure.
You feel like Coach Downing was kind of just getting into a groove? Pretty good play call in the last couple of weeks. You feel like he's like in a groove as far as the play call and design?
Yeah, I feel like Todd's done a really good job so far this year. You know, I think that sometimes as players we haven't executed well, especially down in the red zone, and that's on us. But Todd's done a good job of putting drives together, getting us marching down the field, and giving us opportunities. So, you know, in my opinion, he's done a great job.
Ryan, you guys had like 20-some guys, I think, on the injury report this last week. To be sitting here 3-2, I mean, you take some pride in the fact that you'll have overcome a good bit so far.
Yeah, no doubt we've overcome a lot. You know, I think it's football, right? So guys are going to get banged up, but we've had some stretches where we've had a lot of guys banged up. And anytime that happens, it really tests your depth of your team. And our guys have stepped in. We've had guys, you know, Corey Levin stepped in today and played a bunch of snaps for us up front when Roger went down. So just having that plug-and-play mentality that no matter who's out there, you know, we have to rise to the occasion and make something happen. It's been a pillar of this program, and hopefully we can carry it forward.
Kind of speaking on that, I think with one drive we had maybe six different guys touch the ball, a couple of handoffs, you know, a couple of catches. How much energy does that bring to a team, maybe to the huddle, when you've got so many people involved?
Well, that, you know, I think it includes everybody, right? When you get multiple people touching the ball, everyone feels like they're involved, and you're sustaining that drive, so you're building momentum as you move down the field and getting everyone excited. So there was some really fun points today where we could feel the momentum building within the huddle, and we were able to sustain those drives and get points.
We're going to see Derek walk in here with an Aggie hat. Did he lose a bet?
He lost a bet, but I should have made it wearing an A&M jersey into here. But I don't think he'll be wearing that.